The prince, accompanied by the British ambassador to Uganda, Kate Airey, arrived at Bulange Mengo at 10 a.m. amidst tight security throughout the area. Vehicles accessing the venue were thoroughly inspected by police and sniffer dogs as other officers were regulating the flow of traffic. Prince Edward, Duke of Edinburgh, was welcomed amid his celebrations led by a police band and traditional dances. The prince, who chairs the Duke of Edinburgh International Award Program, was received by Charles Peter Mayiga, Prince David Chintu Wasaja, Dr. Christine Nabaloga, and Prince Chweja Junju. Later, the prince and his entourage visited the premier's office to discuss a number of issues.
She's the one. And
no pressure.
And Prince Wasaja was born shortly after the 1966 turmoil. Actually, his mother was taken to prison when the military stormed the palace.
Another meeting was held in the cabinet room where both kingdoms signed a memorandum of understanding to skill and train the youth. Mayiga applauded Prince Edward, Duke of Edinburgh, for this MOU, emphasizing that it is in line with the Buganda Kingdom's targets.
We held discussions with members of the Duke's team and agreed to a collaboration through a memorandum of understanding between the Kingdom and the Duke of Edinburgh's International Award. When we partner with the Duke of Edinburgh's International Award and bring the youth together, enable them to learn new skills, and encourage them to be resilient, we shall be working towards a future filled with hope.
Prince Edward emphasized that while access to formal education is vital, many of life's greatest lessons happen beyond the classroom. The Duke of Edinburgh's International Award gives young people the chance to discover more through skilling. Mayiga father thanked all those who helped in the preparations to welcome the prince and other dignitaries.
He's the second duke to visit the kingdom in nearly 62 years. It is a big privilege for me, for members of Buganda's royal family, for my colleagues here, and for the other leaders and the people of Buganda, to receive your Royal Highness this morning.
Historic photos were taken before the departure. Report by Ronald Kakoza for the news.